Hello, everybody. I'm Henry Lee. Today, we are very honored to have a guest lecturer, Mr. Yang Yuanwei. His convenient English name on Facebook is Bill Yang, if you want to search for his Facebook under Bill Yang. Yuanwei is his first Chinese name. So we can call him Mr. Yang or Master Yang. Mr. Yang and I are both come from Nanjing, Jiangsu province, China. We studied or we graduated from the same high school called the high school affiliated with the Nanjing Normal University, which is a very famous old high school. My father was a principal of the school when teacher Yan was a student in the late 50s, before I was born. He graduated, I believe, in 1960. I was 1977 class. So he is a 1960 class, right? 您是一九六零届是吧，杨老师？
一九六零年离开这个学校的。
对对对，所以那个我看到我们的那个校友录 ，I just I saw a newsletter of the alumni and that features his paintings.He did during the pandemic. I was so impressed. So I decided to give a class, introduce his art, his landscape painting to our audience and students in this class. So I called him and said, can you attend our meeting and give us advice when we try to study your art?He not only promised will come, and later he decided to give us a hands-on lecture for the first time. 那个杨老师不仅就是答应来观摩来给我们指导，而且亲自来给我们做示范。所以we are very honored to have this hands-on class from him via the Zoom internet meeting. For the first time, he'll show us how his masterpieces are produced or painted. Another connection with him is, I just mentioned, my father. And today is the Double Yang Festival in China.Called the Chongyang Jie, double Yang or double ninth, because it's the lunar year, not the ninth of the ninth month in the Chinese calendar. And it's a festival to remember the living elderly people, to pay respect to the elderly, and also a day to remember the deceased.The late parents and the ancestors. So I'm very happy to attribute this class to in remembrance of my father. Yang 老师，请您回忆一下那个您有一次跟我父亲在一次就是同学会是吧？团聚会上，他怎么还记得你？
好，我非常高兴在这里见到大家啊，因为我和李老师和亨瑞的这个家庭的友谊是非常的久远了。他的父亲是我的中学的校长。
I'm very happy to meet everybody here because I have a very close family tie, family friendship with his parents and his family.
我的父亲和这个 Henry 的父亲是同事。
My father was a colleague of his father.
大约在四年，不止四年，大概有十来年以前，在一次同学的聚会上，我见到了Henry的父亲。
In a reunion of the alumni, I met his father, Henry's father.
我想他应该不认识我了，所以我走到他的面前，跟他自我介绍，我说：“李校长，你还记得我吗？”
I thought he must have forgotten me, so I approached him and asked, Principal Lee, could you recognize me?
他看了我上下看了一下，他很清楚地回答我：“你是那个会画画的杨远威。”我真的非常感动。
He looked at me for a second and said, very clearly, you are that student who is good, he was good at painting. Your name is Yang Yuanwei. He not only recognized his name, but also recognized his painting.
我这次在美国呢，因为我在芝加哥。 Henry 在洛杉矶，我们又建立了非常密切的联系，共同讨论绘画，非常开心。好了。
Henry is and I are both in America, and he's in LA. I'm in Chicago, and we often discuss Chinese painting because we share the same interest, and we are very happy.
好了，我没有了。OK，我想那现在就请您开始那个讲正式讲课吧。好，这个我刚才说了啊，我们今天这堂课呢，我是非常愿意把它给讲好的，因为我们今天李老师跟我说的题目是这个讲我的这个。 层次山水画，就是这个讲我的这个层次山水画，所以我们题目呢就不展开，就集中在用水墨画层次山水这个题目上。Okay,
today, I was invited to give a lesson on landscape painting. And I decided to focus on a area which I'm specialized in, which is the urban scenery. And I prepared to give an in-depth lesson.
因为这个题目的产生是因为 在传统的中国山水画里面，没有或者说很少有人把城市作为题材的，所以它没有现成的这个前人给我们留下的一套的完整技法。Because
the urban scenery has no previous set of techniques left from the ancestors in traditional Chinese landscape painting.
那么这个我想呢，首先我跟大家谈一两个我自己的体会，供朋友们做参考啊。那个。So
I'll share some of my experience to help to serve as a reference to your study.
我们画城市，不是为了把城市重现在我们的画面上。We're
not purposely to portray the cityscape to realistically present it on our painting.
因为这个问题，摄影术已经 非常好的 解决了这个问题。
Because photography has already solved that issue.
而且我们再现城市，把这个城市的风景再现在我们的画面上，也没有什么意义。
It doesn't make any sense to represent the realistic city on a brush painting.
我们画城市和画其他的风景一样，是把我们通过眼睛感受到的景物和我们的这个和我们的感受啊做一个共鸣。就是我们画这个城市的风景呢，是主要是把我们对于城市的感受体现在画面上。
So, the purpose of doing a painting with a city scenery is to express our feeling about that city.
我多说两句啊，就是说，我们画一个，比方说画芝加哥，我们五个人一起去，我们每个人画出来的芝加哥是不一样的。那也就是说，我们表现的是我们对芝加哥的感受。
For example, if we go to Chicago, in a group of five, everybody will have a different feel about that city. So everybody's painting must be different.
所以我们的画不是要像芝加哥，而是要像我们的感受。
So our painting should represent the sensation of Chicago, a personal sensation of Chicago, not a photograph recap of the city.
这是我们画风景画一个非常重要的原则。其实不但画城市，画所有的风景都是一样的。
This is the highest principle of doing any landscape, not only urban landscape.
从这个意义上讲，那么我们画城市的建筑，这个房子有三个窗户还是五个窗户不重要。
So when we paint a building, it is not important to count the number of windows, whether it's five or three, it doesn't matter.
可以由我们的感受来决定。
It all depends on what we feel about it.
我们不是建筑师。
We're not architect.
我们的画的房子会不会倒？没有关系。
It doesn't matter if the house we draw will fall or not.
我们可以把那个干巴巴的房子，我们可以把干巴巴的房子画得好看。就可以了。
The most important thing is to beautify, to make the building beautiful.
有的时候，他们的墙壁可能不是直的，是斜的。
So we can make the wall slant, lean, instead of straight.
一切都取决于我们在一眼看去这个景物我们感受到的是什么。
It all depends on how we perceive the scenery.
好，这是我想讲的第一个问题。
That's my first point.
第二个问题。
The second.
我们画城市里的房子，我们可以不可以把这个房子也看成是我们看过的大山、大树。
The second point is, can we imagine the buildings that we see as if they are rock, mountain, Or big trees.
为了我们把这个城市的建筑画好，我们可不可以把这个城市像我手里的这一张图片一样，把这些山就看成我们眼里的房子，不是也很漂亮吗？
So can we imagine that the buildings in the city look like those rocks, those mountains that are seen in this landscape photograph. If we could paint as beautiful as those rocks.
这个风景，朋友们可能会很熟悉，它的大小、前后、远近很漂亮。那么我们的房子可不可以也是这样呢？
Can we make the buildings look like this beautiful place that you most of many of you might have seen in it's the Zhangjiajie, I believe. So the distant mountain, the skyrocketing rocks, are they just like the city? Can we make the city look like this landscape?
如果你能这样想，我说朋友们，如果你能这样想，那么在你眼前的建筑会一下子活跃起来了。
If you could think in this way, the buildings in front of you will start to dance and to act.
那么这样的景物我们看过很多，那它这也是，这是比较，这个也是
another example of this kind of scenery in nature.
我们可不可以就用这种方法来安排我们大大小小高高低低的建筑呢？
Can we arrange the buildings skyscrapers according to this natural stones and the hills, the rocks.
其实我们的前辈也做过这样的事情。你比方说，这也是一个著名的画家宋文志先生的画，他画的房子，我就想他会给我一个启发。我们的建筑也用这种方法来安排，是不是好看一点？
This is a masterpiece by Song Wenzhi, a famous master in Nanjing. His painting is a portrait of the Huangshan, the Yellow Mountain landscape. Can we borrow his technique and perspective to paint our buildings in the same way?
我觉得我们如果能够这样想，我们的思想就可以活跃起来。
If we can think this way, our mind image will start to emerge.
好，这是第二个。第三个问题，我们来看层次。
The third point, let's look at some pictures of cities.
那么我为了排除色彩对我们的干扰，排除让我把它拍成了，我把它印出了黑白片。
We must filter out the color.
更容易让我们用水墨来考量它。
To make it easier to think in sumi.
那么我想讲的第一个问题是，这个第三个问题是，我们在中国宣纸上画这个城市的风光，我们要发扬我们的这个材料的优点。就是说，就是这个，比方说啊，我们和水彩画比较，我们有些景物 用水彩画来表现，可能是非常方便的。
We must to take advantage of the feature of our media, that is the absorbent rice paper, which is very different than watercolor paper. With watercolor, it's much easier to use color.
可是用我们的这个宣纸来画呢，这个角度是不能，是不方便，比方说这张图。
For watercolor, some perspective is easy to present. But on rice paper, some perspective are not easy. For example, this picture.
比方这张图它用水彩来表现是非常方便的。
If you use watercolor to paint a street scene like this, it's very convenient.
仰视，仰视。
You look up from the street level.
可是用我们的水墨画来画，就很不方便。
If you use a brush and ink, it's not very convenient, not very easy.
我在这里想告诉大家的就是，我们要选一个合适的观察的角度。
So the viewpoint in Sumi, Chinese brush painting, must be different from watercolor.
这个是俯视。
This is a bird's eye view.
那个，我觉得俯视也不太合适。我发现最合适的用水墨画画城市的角度是无人机的角度。
Even you look at from a top of a building, it's not high enough. We must take advantage of the drone, the drone camera, a video is the best these days.
也就是平视或者稍微的俯视。
So it gives an angle that is above, but about the highest level of the building. So we look at the apogee, but in the flat perspective, that's about the height, I think, of the drone.
比方这个角度，我觉得是比较合适用水墨画来画城
市。This is the best angle I found to paint skyline of a city.
就是平视和适当的俯视。
Okay, it's leveled and downward perspective, you understand? Leveled at the height of the building, downward, looking downward.
再还有一个小的问题呢，就是说我们要会用照片。
Another minor issue is we must learn how to use photograph as a reference.
我们用照片不是为了画照片。
We are not going to copy the photograph, never.
用照片，我们在参观一个风景的时候拍一点照片。
The reason we took pictures.
有两个作用。
There are two purposes for taking pictures as a reference.
第一个是帮我们回忆起那个现场的气氛。
It to help record the ambience, the atmosphere of the place. Help us to recall that atmosphere.
第二个是解决我们很多没有记住的细节。
The second reason is to help us remember the details that we cannot remember take into memory from memory when we paint.
这些细节会使我们将来的作品非常的丰富。
These details will help to enrich our future landscape painting in ink and brush.
我们画速写往往是记录不下来的。
If we just rely on a fast, quick sketch, you won't get all the details as a photograph.
好，下面我请大家看一点，看一点我过去的几年里画过的一些，画过的一些城市的，我走过的这个画城市的路，请大家
来看。I'd like to give you a retrospective of my experience in painting cities from a book.
那个，请大家看看这个，就是我这个画过的城市的画，这是一幅画的那个东欧国家捷克的首都布拉格，布拉格的夜晚的风景。
This is a night scenery I did the Prague, the capital city of Czechoslovakia, right? Czechoslovakia.
用了一点点颜色，只有一点点，不重要。
Just tiny bit of color.
我就想表现的就是月光下的城市。
I try to paint the city under moonlight.
有一点惨白，惨白。
It's a very a pale white gray.
这个是画的意大利的。意大利这个罗马的一个西班牙广场。
It's a Spanish square in Italy.
这个视频灯光下的效果不是很好。就这个地方叫做西班牙广场了。实际上是西班牙人、西班牙过去大使馆在罗马的这个地方。所以他叫这个很有名。
It's the embassy of Spanish.
好像那个有个著名的电影叫《罗马假日》。
There's a famous movie called The Holiday in Rome.
就用这个取了很多景。
The background here.
像这个里的处理，在这一块的处理，因为大家看不很清楚啊，这一块的处理，我觉得是比较好的，显示了我们宣纸上的特点。
The upper part, I'm satisfied because it's best represented the characteristic of Chinese painting on rice paper.
这张画，我画的是，
维也纳。
我1985年到维也纳去。住了两个月，这里画的是一张，也是有灯光啊。
Yeah, this is a landscape, a cityscape I did after I lived in Vienna for 2 months.
因为我不想画的非常具体，我这张画的题目叫做《回首》，就是回首维也纳。我想表达这个。那一瞬间我转回头去告别维也纳时候的感觉感受。
I try to express my feeling of the last memory, last glance before I left the city, my feeling about that city. It's an expression of the city in my memory.
威尼斯。
Venice.
那是十年前去的。威尼斯。
Years ago.
我看几张啊。这张画的是也是个夜景，是美国有个城市，在 Ohio 的一个城市叫 Columbus，
Columbus, Ohio. It's
also a night scene. I want to show you, everyone can see my house will fall down.
My buildings all look falling, right?
我想表现的就是月光下城市的感觉。
I try to express the feeling of the city, in moonlight.
这个是我最喜欢的芝加哥，好的，芝加哥，我们这个城市是一个给你留下一个非常坚强、非常强大的一力量的一个城市。
This is the place I live currently, Chicago. I try to express the feeling of a majestic, the very strong, very majestic.
我发现这个美国人很喜欢这种话吧。
I found American viewer favor this style the most.
我连续三年给这个美国有一个我们芝加哥有个机构叫做世界妇女组织、它的慈善拍卖、我每次都送他一张这样的画去慈善拍卖都卖最高价、
For the past 3 years, every year I donate one of this kind of painting to a auction for American Women Society or something. Anyway, each time it made the highest, the top bid in the auction.
这个组织叫 IWA.
IWA
is the organization.
World Women Organization, Association.
主席，他的这个主席啊，每次见到我都要和我拥抱，感觉他认为这个话美国人很喜欢。
So every time that the organizer of the auction got feedback that this style is their favorite.Of the donors.
这个画呢是画的纽约的 Chinatown.
This is the Chinatown scenery in New York.
20年以前的。
20 years ago.
比较破旧了。
It's a kind of old looking.
最后看一张。这个是澳大利亚 Australia 的一个城市叫布里斯班。
Brisbane's night scenery in Australia.
这张画我给自己出的题目是，我给自己出了一个题目，就是我只允许我自己用三种颜色。
I limited myself with only three colors.
用三种颜色来表现。夜晚
to express the night feel.
绿、黄，还有墨。
Black and green.
这个非常有趣。
It's very interesting game.
小辉是不是太慢了？
刚好是。
啊，刚好啊，这个这样扯得远一点啊。扯得远点，这个是我3年以前在芝加哥开的一个画展。3年以前在芝加哥开了一个画展，那么我把我的一些写生，这个里面很多是画的城市啊，比方这一张画的是意大利的教堂。
This is a catalog of a women show I had 3 years ago.The first painting is a Roman church.
这个就是芝加哥。
Another version of Chicago downtown.
我悄悄地说一句，非常好卖。
It's a bestseller of mine.
好了，那么我们进入正题啊，我们开始，那么我们讲怎么画，好不好？
Now let's talk about how to paint.
那么今天因为我们不是在野外，我们今天是在室内，我就选了一张图片。
Because we are not plein air today, outdoor today, so I use a photo reference.
这张图片呢是纽约。
It's a
纽约。
Scenery.
这个是很著名的标志性的建筑。
It's a landmark building.
我想我画这个，就是画这张这个风景的作品，给画给大家看。
I will do a demo based on this picture.
那么小辉要不要再看看那些原作啊？要不要？
要那个第一张是吧？就是你那个
不，就是那些原作第一张或者第一张也可以，就是我讲哪几张原作给他们看，好不好
？OK, yeah.
那画两张嘛，看两张。
Before I paint, I will explain some technique.
看两张
with my
看两张，看两张好吗
？Original paintings.
这个是 我们看看原作啊，原作可能比画册好一点。这是我最近画的一张 New York
original painting. It looks better than a print.
画的布鲁克林大桥。
This is a representation of the Brooklyn Bridge.
它是比较难画的，因为这个墙是一个非常僵硬的死板的这个建筑。
This is a very difficult subject matter to paint because the structure is very mechanical.
这个 我想这里的用笔应该是符合小辉老师过去跟你们讲过的这个中国山水画或者是花鸟画的用笔方法。
You might recognize this kind of brush stroke you learned from Henry's class from traditional painting.
那么这个僵硬的建筑怎么呢接受我这个比较随意的用笔
？How can we make the stiff structure to accept our expressive brush stroke.
我采取的办法就是墨团和线条的结合，线条和墨团相结合。
My trick is to combine ink blob and line outline, ink wash and line.
用这个比较含混的，就是这个比较含混变化的这个效果和这个比较坚硬的效果产生对比。
And make contrast between the solid dark steel structure with the blurry cars or elements in the other part.The lower part.
用不同的用笔和技巧，像这些，我们都可以研究这技巧。不同的技巧。
There are, much. It has much to do with the traditional techniques. On the upper part of the bridge, the distant buildings.
产生对比。
To create a contrast between dark and light, dry and wet.
我告诉大家，这些都不是随意的。
I want to make sure that these are not accidental effect.
都是精心安排的。
These are all well planned and executed effect.
再看一张啊，我们就开始画画啊。
Let's take one more look of another painting. I will start to paint.
非常非常有意思，谢谢老师。
哎呀呀呀，谢谢谢谢。这也是纽约，有一点这个景象，有一点啊，有一点。这一张画我觉得应该向大家推荐的是，怎么把这个这么多的房子前前后后远远近近的对比起来。
The challenge is how can we make all those building blocks to complement each other with dark light and black white front and back.
我们这个对比不是为了对比而对比，是要这个画面好看。
The contrast is not for the sake of a contrast. The purpose is to make the painting beautiful.
在这个中国水墨画里有一种很多人他画得很潇洒，刷刷刷几下。
Some people in Chinese painting, they feel very, you know, free with the whipping brush stroke, spontaneous strokes.
刷刷刷，很痛快，很痛快。
可是 intuitive.
两分钟，别人就不愿意看了，因为它不丰富。
It only takes 2 minutes to do a painting.But it doesn't make the painting with lasting interest for the viewer to see.
我说的就是要像这里要把它画得丰富起来，别人愿意看五分钟，看十分钟。
I want to engage the audience to stare at my painting for 5 minutes or even 10 minutes.
要有丰富的内容，就是我们的笔触啦，水墨浓淡，要让观众有东西看。
We must include enrich our painting with the various elements, so they have things to look at.
这样一张画呢，才能够真正做到，就是这个不是一眼看，一会儿就不想看了。
So this kind of painting will have a longer interest, long-lasting interest, not just complete in one glance.
好，那么我们下面今天只能简单的说这么一点，我们开始画画，好不好？
Okay, limited by time, let's start painting.
下回啊，我就慢慢扯啊，慢慢扯啊，啊，我慢慢扯啊。
哎，
好，这个这样，我先讲一些技术性的问题，好吧？
嗯。Okay, let's start about some technical notes, some technical tricks.
中国的宣纸多种多样。
There are so many varieties of Chinese rice paper, xuan paper.
品种非常多。我最近选择的呢，这种宣纸呢，不是一个十分昂贵的宣纸。
It's not the most expensive rice paper.
我想在亨瑞老师这里啊，是可以找得到的。
Yes, we will carry this kind of paper. Yeah, I just learned he used a specific kind of xuan paper. It's not the most expensive brand, but it's the most suitable for his style.
我选择的纸呢，不是太薄，不是太薄。
My requirement for the paper is a little thicker than normal.
它比较厚呢，就是这个画建筑的时候，笔下的感觉呢丰富一些。
It gives
比较厚
more depth than thin version.
前天我和造纸厂的，就是这个造宣纸的朋友聊天，聊了一会儿。小辉，我讲点简单的，不要紧吧？
没关系，没关系。
我讲这个，我和造纸厂的朋友聊天，为什么说这种纸啊，这么便宜，这么好用？
I asked a fellow friend who is working in a paper mill why this paper is so good but not so expensive.
这种纸叫檀皮宣。
This paper is called the Qingtan bark paper. Qingtan tree bark paper.
它的特点就是它为什么便宜呢？因为它的料用料和普通的宣纸不同。它的用料呢，它檀皮是用的生檀皮，不是用的熟檀皮。
Okay, the bark used in this paper is not mature or not cooked, it's raw.
它的草料不是用的这个沙田，这个这不是沙田稻，它不是，它用的是我们这个一种叫纸浆，用的中这个西洋造纸的一种纸浆。
He said the instead of using the traditional rice straw fiber in addition to the bark, they used just a conventional industry paper paste, what we call the material, paper making material, the contemporary industry paper making material.
它的缺点呢，就是比较僵硬。
The shortcoming of this paper is a little stiffer than the traditional rice paper, the straw rice paper.
我采取的办法呢，就是我把这个纸在画以前，我把它揉一下。
To overcome that shortcoming, we must do something. And my trick is to crinkle the paper first before I paint.
揉一下的，让这个纸的纤维互相纤维松一点。
To loosen up the structure of the fiber of this paper by crumbling.
第二个呢，它揉过以后的纸呢，表面是不平的。
Another reason to crinkle the paper is to make the surface not so even.
就让我们将来画建筑的时候呢，那个线条呢不会太光太直。
With the pumps, our line would be rougher or coarse than machine-made paper or a shining surface.
可以让我们画的建筑的笔触丰富一点。
You will make the texture much richer with a crinkled paper.
但是请朋友们注意，宣纸一揉，正反面就分不清了。
However, you must remember which side is the front, which side is the back, because after crumbling, you cannot tell.
所以在揉以前，我在纸的反面做一个记号。
So I mark the corner of the back side.
纸的反面做个记号。
On the back side, I make a mark.
我将来可以变。
So I can tell which side is the front, which side is the back.
在揉的时候不要太用力，免得把这个纸会揉破的。
So, when we crumble the paper, do not use too much force to avoid breaking the paper.
我揉啊。
So, not let's start.
动作轻柔一点。
To be very gentle first.
慢慢的。不要
very slowly, gently.
不要用猛的力量，慢慢的揉。
Don't use too much force. Very gently.
它这样的那个纸张的纤维呢，就可以松动一点。
This will loosening up the structure of the texture, the paper texture.
然后我们放平纸张也要注意。
There is a method to flatten the paper.
找到哪个是反面。
First, identify the wrong side from the front side.
好，这个是反面。然后用手抚摸反面，不能摸正面。
Use your palm to flatten the paper from the back side.
抚摸反面，抚摸反面，不摸正面。
Never touch the front.
因为我们手上有油和汗。
Because the sweat, oily sweat from your palm.Will stain the paper if you do this on the front.
那么如果摸正面，那个纸就太滑了。
You will make the paper slippery if you use if you touch your paper from front, flatten the paper from front. So you must flatten the paper from backside, like this.
我觉得这个时候的纸啊，就像煮饭已经煮熟了一样，很好。
Now I feel the paper is ready, prepared, just like a cooked rice, ready to consume, to eat.
好，我们开始研究啊。每个画家的习惯不一样。
Everybody has a different, habit.
我习惯于用炭条。
I'm used to draw my composition with a charcoal, a soft charcoal.
但是我不是用炭条来勾画，把这个画画完整，不画完整。
I'm not going to use a charcoal to sketch the whole thing.
那么我们怎么想呢？我讲我的想法啊，你们不一定会跟我想的一样，没关系。
I thought the process.
我觉得这张照片呢，我不能照它全画，我取其一段。
I'll select a part of this painting to begin with.
我这一段我就觉得它。比较入画，比较丰富。
Because I think this part is more suitable for.
我取这一段，这一块，这一块。
This right side of the picture, is richer than the other part.
它有，因为大家看的没有我清楚了，我也没办法了。它有很丰富的大大小小的房子。我为什么选它？我跟大家说啊
，There are different form and shape of building here.
它有很多的大小的这个形状的在里面，我们就好画。
It's easier for us to paint.
有很多趣味，有横的，有竖的啊。黑暗的里边有一个明亮的房子。
There is some contrast and the texture and some pattern.
它这里有很多的细节。
There are a lot of details here.
没有细节，将来不好办。
If you don't have this kind of detail, we cannot create on our own.
但是我不能照它这个画。这里的房子，如果我需要，我都可以把它挪进来。
However, we can also borrow elements from the surrounding buildings, if we need. So we don't want to copy everything.
就是只要符合我的这个时候的感觉，只要符合我这个时候的感觉，这些房子都可以挪出、挪进。
We can move them around if, according to our needs and feel.
只要 好看。
Yeah, to make a painting more beautiful than the picture.
好，那么我下面开始画。我这个时候画呢，我这个炭条就是帮助我固定一些，形状。就是我觉得这些形状我不能让它过线。我现在开始啊，比方说我有些，我这画一个线条，我就是不让它过线而已。
Okay, these marks are the limit I want to set. So when I paint with the brush, I won't pass. It sets the boundary. Set some, it map out the limit.The highest, I guess. Do not align those lines. Try to vary.Do not put them on the same line.
一张距离让它有变化，不要一样长。
Also vary the distance, the length of each line.
这个时候在我的心里已经有一张画了。
At this point, I already have a mind image, a mental representation of my painting.
可以了。
That's all.
朋友们，大家注意，一定要有想象力。这个时候，你看到这张纸，你可以想象。我把照片给大家。
Yeah,
我把这个房子。It's
very important to imagine your finished the painting at this point.
挪进来了，挪进来了，我挪到这里了。我觉得这个单是这块景太平。太平了，这个不太好看，我把它减弱了，我把它挪到这里去了，我把它拉进来了。
I switched these two buildings to make the
这个，因为你我们画这个风景，我画芝加哥，画纽约，还要是特别让人一眼就能认出来的建筑啊，要画一点。
I have to include this landmark as the focal point.
那么我在按在这里，但是我不画。我知道我固定的这一点是塔尖。
That's the highest apogee of the tower, but I'm not going to paint that to focus.
我不画了，一画了以后这个炭条洗不掉嘛。
If I paint with a charcoal, I cannot erase it because it's light.
这个有这个大家熟悉的建筑呢，可能看的人会亲切一点。
This building is very important to make the painting more sellable to the locals.
因为今天我这个画呢是一边讲话一边在画，可能注意力不够集中，不一定能成功。那就是说，你跟大家说，我平常的画这种水墨画，由于随意性啊，我的成功率还不到50%。
I'm teaching at the same time when I paint, so the success rate is lower than normal. Even in normal situation, when I paint alone, the success rate is only 50% or less.
今天要讲话，那所以更分心嘛，更不是很专心的啊。
So today I may have a lower success rate, because I'm talking at the same time.
那么用两句话来说一说墨。
Let's talk about ink in two sentences.
我习惯于用中国墨汁，墨汁就是买来的墨汁。
I'm used to
用墨汁
bottled ink.
用墨汁加水，用墨汁加水。
And combined with grind ink from water.
大概两倍的水，一倍的一份墨汁。
The proportion is one portion of bottled ink with two portions of clean water, then grind into a paste.
在砚台里，再用墨锭，墨锭，再用墨锭把它磨浓。
Use ink stick to grind that mixture until it become dark.
我向大家说为什么这样呢？因为这个墨汁的制造，它使用了工业炭黑。
Because the bottled ink, they used the industrial charcoal.
它这个工业炭黑呢，它的磨的这个颗粒呢，比我们手工磨的要细。
The particle is much finer than the grind ink.
它的好处是特别的黑。
The advantage of bottled ink is the hue is very dark.
缺点呢，就是大家可以试一试，把这个墨汁啊放在盘子里，用水化开以后啊，它的这个黑发出一种比较冷的光。
But the hue is a little cooler than the traditional ink stick.
而我们手工磨的这种叫做油烟墨、书画墨、油烟墨，它的黑是一个温暖的黑。
The tone oil soot ink stick give us a warmer, black, warmer black.
所以我觉得这样，加水研磨以后的这个砚台里的墨呢，特别好。
So the combination of the two are the best.
这个是供大家参考啊，每个人会有不同的。那么我们调墨的时候一般是喜欢这样啊，我先在瓷盘里倒一点水，一点点水，让我的墨呢进去以后会混合起来，不要让它，我这个笔呢比较大，用比较大的笔。我开始画啊，
I mix a little water with the dark ink to make a dark gray to start with.
第一个小问题，从哪里画起？从最黑的画起，还是从最淡的画起？
So where to start? Do we start from the lightest or the darkest?
我的习惯是，这个大家都可以啊，都可以从最浓的和最淡的画起。我习惯是从中间的墨色画起。
You could start from the lightest or the darkest if you like, but my habit is to start from the mid-tone or the mid-value, the gray.
请大家注意，墨不要一样浓。
Try to vary the tone of the ink. You're using a blotting paper to stop the bleeding, smear ink if needed.
跑到合适的位置就吸一下。
When it has reached the preferred position, extension, stop it with blotting.
大家注意啊，这个笔是要很要有变化，有这样，有这样，有这样，有这样，有这样，不要形成一样的墨团。
Notice the variation of ink marks.Some slant, some straight, some large, some small. Do not paint in the same pattern, in the same shape.
这个时候他已经把我心里面的大概的感觉固定了。
Now it starts to embody my mind image.
下面我用浓一点的墨。
Now let's turn to darker ink.
我还可以停一下，就是让它稍微，这个湿的墨呢，让它稍微走动一下，走到不要干不干透啊，不要让它干透。但是现在还
有一个学生问你用的笔是什么笔？
我就是用。用的最普通的大的这种狼毫笔，狼毫笔，
狼毫，
狼毫笔，
Wolf hair or stiff hair, large size.
你讲讲师范他们懂吧？讲师范他们懂不懂？
师范懂，
懂，
就是major hair, large. We have this brush in our store, large major hair brush.
嗯嗯，
我们有这个笔叫
啊
大师范。
大师范，那么这个师范，现在我下面开始勾一部分线，勾一部分线，不勾完，我开始勾，勾这个房子，但是我只勾一部分，我用比较浓的墨啊。
Please mute yourself and see who's making.
这是比较黑的啊，大家可能镜头里看不很清楚，这是比较黑的。
These are darker ink lines, strokes than the previous strokes.
这个浓墨部分可以进入刚才画的墨团，部分不全部进入，可以部分进入刚才我们的墨团。大家看，部分进入。
This dark ink can partially overlap with the lighter ink spots to break it a little bit, but not completely wet into wet. Partially wet into wet, not completely overlap. So it break, we call it that breaking ink, but not wet into wet. Some dry, some wet, yeah.
为了突出这个建筑的这个硬的感觉，线条露一点出去，这些露出来的线条没有坏处。生活中间的这个房子不会有一个线条，不会有这种尖角，对不对？但是我们有意露出来，可以让别人看的时候呢，有房屋坚固的那种感觉。I
purposely make those sharp corners to make it feel more like the concrete building. To make it look firm.
有的时候擦一擦，大家看擦的效果，可以产生一种，现在是浓墨勾的，对吧？我下面把它变淡，再用淡墨勾，干勾什么呢？勾这个阴影里的房子。Okay,
you can also use dry brush stroke, and lighter ink to draw the shady part of the building.
衬湿，一部分在干的地方，一部分在湿的地方，它会产生不同的奇妙的效果。
It's very important to paint why the previous layer is still wet and with partial overlapping. That increases the texture, the interest of ink. Partially wet into wet in different value, different tones.
好，我让它干一会儿，我跟大家说个道理啊。
Let's pause here, and I will explain something.
这个景物我们看过去，每个地方我们都会看得非常的清晰。It's
very clear when we look at this scenery.
看这里很清晰。 看这里也会很清晰，可是我们看整个画面的时候，那就要分出它的该清晰的和该模糊的。Okay,
when we look at actual scenery, everywhere is clear. But when we organize our painting, you have to distinguish. To make a hierarchy of where is clear, where is blurry. Not all clear.
也就是说，你画这个次要的地方，不能用画这个地方那么认真的态度来画它。
So the focal point should be more clear than the an important part. You cannot evenly make them all clear. The principle is to make the painting with host and guest are the main role and the supporting roles.
好，下面我画这一块。这一块是比较远，比较不重要的地方，我们要画的。
The left side is the farther and unimportant in my composition.
保留里边的浓淡变化。
It's important to keep the value contrast.
用一支笔，感觉太单调。
I feel like if you paint the entire painting with only one brush, it feels very boring.
这个时候，那个换一个另外一种笔，可以让它我们所有的线条呢换一点变化。这是一支什么笔？大家看啊。
Can introduce another brush at this point.
很硬很硬的笔都已经破开了。
I'm using a split brush.
我可是我线条怎么用呢？我这样用。就是两根线条一起走。
I use the split tip, but align them to create a double line or something.
目的是什么？目的是趣味变化。
The point is to make more variation in the line to create more interest for the viewer.
要考虑到在湿的地方画，它的效果是在变的。
You have to take account of the wet into wet Because this part, the ink is going to change. To expand, yeah.
Because
the difference to brush, the effect is different from the previous strokes.
所以在刚才画过的地方，我们还可以画一些，画一些以后呢，让它的那个变化呢就比较多了。
So if you use a different brush to reinstate the parts we already painted earlier, you'll make more.
我就讲这条线，我们有个经常的习惯，就是这里有一块白，这块白我觉得不够丰富，我要加一条线。往往这条线，很多人会不自觉的画在中间，一定要有所倾斜，就我这根线一定不能在正中间。
For example, this white space between the darks, I want to enrich that, but most people, most students will put the line right in the middle. I would never do that. It always leans to one side, not in the middle of the white. If you add something,
我这种做法完全是为了画面丰富，需要一些。
All I'm doing is to enrich the visual appearance. 干笔是吧？
干笔插在快干没有干的这个上面，就是快干没干的时候，我擦一些这种笔在上面。
Use a thirsty brush to go over some about to dry, not yet dry strokes. It will enrich it. Thirsty dark brush go over the dark light will enrich.
实际上就是我们那个所谓泼墨，泼嘛。
It's one of the so-called breaking ink technique. Breaking ink.
请大家注意，这个边缘的处理和这个边缘的处理一定要不一样。
Yeah.
这个我是画到实实的画到边，这里我就含含糊糊的。
Look at the two sides. It's different. On the right side, I paint solid, break the edge of the frame. But on the left side, I purposely avoid the hard, the dark near the edge to make it soft. To soft out, fog out.
Yeah. 这个地方我还要画的，但是我现在不画它。为什么呢？我留着，让干透，让这些边缘线保留。待会儿我用吹风机吹，吹干了以后，我再染。This
part is not finished yet, but you cannot keep working on this. We must wait it dry, and we can use a hair dryer to dry it first before we continue.
染一个比它浅的一个层次。
Later, I'll add a lighter wash.
现在不动它了。
We cannot put that right now. It's still wet. I just recap. He started in medium or mid dark, and then goes darker. Later would go lighter. Yeah. And this
我画这个建筑，画它。下面我画它，好吧？下面我来画它啊。下面我来画这个建筑，就是这个。这个建筑的位置很重要，不能在中间。这个建筑的位置很重要，不能在中间。
This is really important for this landmark building, or the focal point, not right in the middle. It must avoid the center line.
画这种建筑，画这种尖的建筑，不是从上画到下，是从下画到上。
Notice the order. When I do this pointed tower, I always start from the bottom of the tower, not from top down, from bottom up.为什么呢，老师？
我个人感觉这样，这个像盖房子一样的，它比较稳当。
哦，
比较稳当，比较稳当。
I feel it's like the way you build the building from the ground up, not from top down, right? It feels more stable this way. Even you're not aligned, like straight.
我比个例子啊，比个例子，我们画里面画小人，画在画里面画小人，一定是先画身体，后画脑袋。
For the same token, when I paint a figure in my painting, I always do the body and then the head.
比较生动。
That always.Make the painting look more active, more alive.
先画脑袋，以后画身体，我就觉得比较僵。
If you paint the head first, the result will be stiff. 杨老师，这是纽约还是芝加哥啊？这个你画的？
在纽约，纽约，在纽约。
啊哈，
这个好像是帝国大厦吧，还是哪里？记不清了。
帝国大厦？
不是帝国大厦，不知道是不是帝国大厦，记不清了、哦。这个刚才房子没画好，没有画好啊。这个我们是说这个成功率不高吗
？Empire State Building，
那是一个标志性建筑。
New York，
这是一个标志性的建筑。
Yeah， look recognized as Empire State Building。The landmark in New York. The Fifth Avenue,
不难看
24th Street. So someone can even tell the place in our class. It's the Fifth Avenue and the 34th Street with the Empire State Building in the distance.
这个房子是我家的。因为我觉得需要。
I add this building because of the pictorial reason for pictorial reason to complete
啪一下
composition.
我这一下就把它两个对比出来了。
你说这个和哪一个？
和它这个，我它了一笔，跟它对比一下。
哦 ，it just echoed the Empire State Building. to create the high and the low rhythm. The building could also be Chrysler building. So she's not sure. Anyway, it's New York, not Chicago. Chrysler, the car maker.
对，克莱斯勒大厦，对，好像是。哦，是，好像是的。克莱斯勒大厦啊，好像是，记不清了。
Yeah, it's confirmed by our teacher. It's Chrysler building.
这张画四个角，我们选择一个角画满，或者选择三个角画满，一个角空白，我觉得比较灵活，不要四个角都画满，我们也不要两个角画满，这四个角里。 有一个或者三个角画满，像这张画，我想一个角画满，就是把这个，把哪个角画满？
So, 右边吗？把这个角画满啊，
So,
把这个角画满。 In one painting, there are four corners. We should never fill them all. You can fill up one, consolidate one corner or three corners, but not both under corners. So only one corner on the bottom should be filled up. The other is a void. So.
这个很重要，这个钱同学一下子就讲了，画四个角不能都画满，但是画一个角或者画三个角，这个。
So it's very extremely important to remember that not to fill up all the corners, only one corner, and leave all the other three with voids, so the painting feels with more breaths of qi. I think 灵活 means more. Vitality and active.
Okay. 还有多少时间？
还有半小时。
这个时候我的衬得半干半湿呢，这个时候完全是在画这个整体的效果了，画这个整体效果了。
As the painting is getting dry, I'm not concerned with the totality of the painting.
好，我把它吹干，好不好？
好。 Now I'm going to dry it with a hair blower. We got a identification of this place. It's 42th Street and Lexington Avenue, the east side of Midtown Manhattan.
最大的目的是为了保留这些痕迹。
The reason to dry it at this point is to heat set the current state.
如果你画画的时间足够，可以不吹，画画的时间等等待。
To wait, you don't have to use a hair dryer.
这个，因为毕竟是课堂里，我适当的简化过程，其实刚才，还是可以再加一些干的画法的，就是在干的时候再画一两遍。但是今天为了考虑时间，我就开始进入一个湿的画法。你大家看啊，我把它喷湿。
Normally, I would use dry at this point to enrich the effect. But today, I jump into the last stage, which is wet wash. So I dried it, and then now I wet it with water again to keep to do the washes wet onto wet. You could do some more dry brushing if you have time before this last stage.
这个时候喷湿呢是喷均匀。这个时候你讲，你说，这个时候喷湿呢，要就是喷匀以后呢，不能化。
First, you spray water evenly all over the paper, but do not paint yet, because the paper is is completely wet, too much water.
那么我要把它的表面的水吸掉。
I must use the blotting paper to take out the extra moisture first.
表面的水吸掉。
To blot off the extra moisture.
吸掉以后呢，这个时候的我们再稍微等一下，让它干一干，稍微等一下。
Wait a few minutes.
我们开始呢，再加一个层次啊。这个时候加的层次是没有墨迹的。So,
we'll do soft wash without brush traces.
加出一个层次来。
To add one more layer, or value.
如果控制一下，不要让它跑得太厉害，让它停住。
Use a blotting paper to stop the stroke from bleeding. Need it.
像这些的形状已经不是很规整了，但是我们需要 你如果干巴巴的画笔直的房子就不好看了，所以我是让它画的活跃，这像花鸟画一样，是吧？
So the concept of doing this kind of landscape is to borrow the method from flower and birds painting.The brush strokes and ink using are very spontaneous. 嗯，very fresh,
这个就是不断的调整，让这个画面丰富。
Now is at the stage to continually adjust the painting to enrich the texture and the details.
基本画完了。
That's almost done.
基本画完了。基本画完了。这张画的水平呢？当然，因为在讲话精力不集中，可以应付一般的展览，可以应付一般的展览，或者笔会可以了，就基本画完了。哦，还再画一点，再画一点，再画一点。
Yeah, he is satisfied.
天空，
the
painting,
and he thinks it's good enough for a group show or something.
天空我要画点云。画一点云呢。
Now he's going to add the cloud.
我不想画的像一般的这个刷一刷云，我想做一个效果。做个效果啊，这个笔我把它擦得很干。
So, first,
很干很干。
I dry the brush to make it very thirsty.
我利用这个纸还没有干透，我处理。
Before the paper gets dry,
注意一些云啊。
Use this thirsty brush to create the shading.
很少很少
very 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 few ink remaining in the brush on semi dry
不要让它跑得太多了
don't let it bleed too much so this is dry on damp paper 那个纸不是很湿啊，就是一点点水汽是吧？
就
就
已
可能
经
一点，
快要干了，
快要干。
这个纸已经快要干了，
So
已经
dry
快要
brush
干。
on damp, almost dry paper, and blotted
那么
with the tissue.
这个效果，它是比较柔、比较混的，和这个建筑呢拉开距离。
The effect I want to achieve is the contrast between the steel, concrete building and the soft, feathery, texture of the cloud, like a cotton, downy, yeah, downy, cloud.
就是一个效果，因为这个我发现镜头里的效果
很
不
好。
好，不好，不清晰，就是没有细微感。
哦，回头你照一张高清的照片，我们
不行啊，我要拖，还要拖，还要拖，就是高清的照片我都觉得很原
如果
作
现
很。
在照的话，就是还没有干的时候，它是平的嘛，对吧？
现在，但是这个灯光也不太好，我可以拍一张，就是不
可以
是
拍一
效果
张，
很
现在
好。
先拍一张，因为你最后发表的给我们学生看就足够
好的，
好，
这张画呢，不能进画册。
啊，我知道。This demo is not good enough for my collection book, but as a demo, it's so-so.
就是给大家看一个意思吧，就是给
Just
大家看一个意思。
to illustrate my method.
大家还有什么问题？我们可以聊聊。
好，那你要休息了吧？
不要紧，不要紧，不要紧，我等，没关系，没关系，待会儿去吃饭，没关系
好
啊，
的，
你，
我们现在打开那个，让他们可以说话好了。
哎。
So the demo is finished. If you have any questions, you can unmute yourself to ask. 永乐，你的最后这个
Yes,
我懂，你最
yes.
后
Hi, 杨老师你好，我叫
你
永
好，
乐，
哦，
我
你
叫
好，你
永
好。
乐，我在布鲁克林公共图书馆工作。
哎呦
我
呦呦
们
呦呦！
啊，我们现在正巧，我现在正在准备一个展览，一个小型的展览。我这个展览的主题是东方与西方的水彩画。那我今天正好看到您画的 Chrysler Building，那我想您有没有其他的纽约市的画？如果您觉得满意的话，能够送给我一张，就是 email，我可以把它 print 出来，放在8×10的相框里面展览吗？
不想，
我
我
知
现
道这
在
是很冒昧
不
的
不，我现在原则上答应你，因为待会儿现在因为
我们在私
上
下
课
再。
不是又要讲话，我原则上答应你，就是
好
现
的，
在又要讲课又要画画，本身这张画画的就我就感觉到我
他
的
说
精
叫你用以
力，
前的一张画，也不要原作，
我知道我知道，
印出
好，
来，因为
只要是纽
我
约
自
就
己。
行，
OK，我会的，
好。
我会
永乐，
到
我
以
们
后
回
传
头
给你。
再跟杨
谢
老师
谢谢谢
细谈
谢谢，
哈，谢
好，没
谢
关系。
永乐。
现在我就觉得我画画要各位也是提供给大家精力要集中，非常专注。这张画呢，我就觉得精力不够集中，一边讲话一边画画，有好多遗憾，控制的不好。这个实际上各位朋友啊，就是控制这个工具，控制这个效果。抓紧时间处理。
杨老师
好，
能够跟我们分享一下哪些地方这幅画还能够更好吗？
总体效果可以的，哦，总体效果呢是这张画还可以的，比较生动，比较生动，就是特别是这个塔没有画好，这个塔叫什么呢？就这个，这 Chrysler 是吧？就这个塔，
Chrysler Building。
就是这张画的总体的味道，那就是总体的黑白的对比是可以的，虚实生动感也是可以的，这个地方处理的还不够复杂，这一块处理的还不够复杂，还不够丰富，这一块形变化是对的。变化的 不理想。这块行，他这个我是让他写像写意花鸟一样的，这个小辉你知道是吧？像写意花鸟一样的，这里面有些东西的，这里面是有很多变化的，但变形变得还不理想，还要再画。所以我说我的成果
这个要求 self critique 太 high， 太 it's too restrictive。For our eyes， 你对我们来讲，你的画已经是 masterpiece 了，非常好，已经好。
还有什么问题？我们聊聊，可以。
那个我太太有两句话要讲，杨老师，我让她
请讲。哎呦，微微请好，微微你好。
没有没有，不敢。我是说那个杨老师非常好。我是想问一下，刚才那个杨老师说的那个50%的那个成功，那指的是什么？主要指的是什么样的？可不可以多说两句关于您认为的、您界定的成功与否 ？Yeah，
就是
50% of the success. What's the standard for that? Thank you.
好，我的想法就是，我们平常啊，我画这个画，我想画一个题材，一个内容，这是一次是。遗憾是很多的，往往要画个两次或者三次一样的，然后比较选一个最好的，其余的呢这就可能就要收掉。这个在绘画的现象里不奇怪。
Yeah,
不奇怪。
Let me translate your answer. Excellent. So the question was why 50% success rate? Professor Yang said normally, he will attempt at the same theme two or three times and select one. So comparable to other versions, this version may be the best. So the rest two would be either destroyed or to be used as, for some other reason. So 我明白了，就是说你一个画要画两次以上。
两三遍，哎。
其中一张好的留下来，这是中国画的特点决定的，是吧？
哎，
对，
这个很多大师一个题材要画个几十张，然后，拿一张出来，有的。
Yeah, it's very common. The Chinese painting masters, will continuously pursue a subject matter for dozens of times to perfect their result.So it's a common process in this kind of media.
这张画放在平时我还会怎么呢？等它干透，自然干透，再用干笔再画，然后再打湿，再画，再干再湿，要三四次。
So normally this painting.Would be retouched three or four times on dry paper, then on wet paper, and then dry paper. So alternatively, dry and wet, alternatively three to four times.
哦，还有什么？各位朋友还有什么意见？
Any other questions?
好，在哪一个地方有图章？
哦，那个 Barbara 问，在什么地方盖图章？
好，问的非常好，问的非常专业。
他在杭州学过四年，杭州中国美院学过四年。Barbara，
你看的，就是这个时候，这个问题问的很专业，你表扬他一下。
You ask a very professional question.
好，这个从画面整体需要来讲，我觉得我会把名字盖在这里，名字签名签一个字或者两个字，盖两个小图章在这里。这个时候画面呢就往下坠了，往下了，然后我再拿一方闲章。一方闲章盖在这个位置上，一方闲章
First, I will sign with a short signature on the lower right with the two small seals. And so now the balance is turned is on the weight is on the right. I will balance that weight with another mood seal on the upper left.
就是一两个字，盖两个章。你看一个这里盖一个章。一般我这个闲章我盖的应该是盖闯荡美利坚。
The mood seal I use is with the content Explore America.
谢谢。Thank
you, Barbara.
谢谢老师，非常有力，谢谢。
谢谢。
永乐还有一个 question 什么？Thank you for great demo. Mr. Yang said that he painted his feeling about the subject. What is the feeling he wanted to express in the painting that he has just demonstrated to us? 他说你在这张画里面你的那个。 感觉你的情绪，你要表达的是什么样的 feeling，
什么样的情绪呢？我就感觉就是因为纽约呢，很雄伟，也很古旧，很老旧，又老又旧，所以我想表现的是一种混沌的感觉，混沌。
My feeling about New York City is a very majestic yet very old. So I try to express that that old and very 混沌是怎么讲 blurry
啊？混沌，就是比方说，你说风雨快要来了，或者说风雨快要去了，那个时候的感觉。
Okay. Especially the weather. Before a rainstorm or just after the rainstorm. 所以你常常画雨景，这样的话有雾啊或者什么的，是吗？对，让画面好看丰富啊。So the best weather for Chinese brush painting is misty, windy or rainy, or night. 有的时候是晚上，是吗？哎，有的时候是晚上。
晚上呢，画月光，月光下
moonlit， yeah.
因为这个城市的风景啊，它太清晰了，必须让它的一部分模糊起来。Okay,
yeah, the challenge of painting cities, thing usually too clear, so we must make it blurry. I think 混沌
is就是模糊的意思，在这里。对对对，混沌比模糊更厚重一点吧。就是这个，让一部分模糊起来以后呢，那么画面才有节奏感。And
to create a rhythmic movement.
You 就是最接近阳，稍微边缘一点点线。
Yeah, I will use two color, a warm color in amber or brown to highlight the lid part.
在这个模糊不清的暗部呢，我想用一点花青，或者是美国人的 indigo.
I will use indigo to wash the shady part.
比较大块的。 大大小小的这个花青或者是indigo，
in blobs of blue， 那个白的还是要保留嘛，对吧？
白的要保留，因为这个不保留就真成了水彩画了。
yeah, we must keep as much possible the whites, otherwise it will become watercolor painting. 所以你不会画那个蓝天吧？
我不想画。
那那个天的颜色会不会再染一下呢？有的时候你会，
有的时候我会染一下，那是因为前面的需要，需要一个东西的时候呢，有的这个这张画不能染，这个天一染就，因为我需要的是云气，云气可以不要颜色。我觉得水墨画不用颜色。
I will not watch the blue sky. In some landscape painting, I watch the sky in blue because the need of the painting. The foreground is already very rich in this painting, so we don't need a dark sky.那杨老师差不多时间就到了，您可能也要休息了。那下一次，下个礼拜四，我们还会继续讨论，好不好？
好，下次
会我也没有机会今天自己画，所以我也很手很痒，要想休息一下。那个下个星期同样的时间，好不好？还是
九点，好，
我们再回来继续讨论。
好，
非常感谢杨老师。在百忙之中为我们做这么好的精彩的讲座，第一次首次
谢第一次
向世界这个
谢谢
展示你的这个绘画过程，非常有意思。然后我们还有很多的那个问题，我们会用书面的或者是
好
到下一次再请教你。
好
那个永乐的那个像邀请你展览的事情，我们私下的去解决。
我跟你联络。好谢谢，
我会给他给你的那个联络方式啊。
好，
那就这样子，
谢谢，
我们就
停止视频了。好，大家再见，各位再见，各位朋友再见，各位朋友再见，谢谢。